Do you remember the autumn of 2017 when Hurricanes Harvey and Irma crashed into Texas, Puerto Rico, and the U.S. Virgin Islands? In the aftermath of those hurricanes, Americans faced a net loss of 33,000 jobs. And of those 33,000 jobs, women lost 41,000 jobs, while men added 8,000 jobs. If we're serious about combating climate change, we must gender mainstream it so that stakeholders of all genders are accounted for in preventive and response measures. Oxford Dictionary named climate emergency as their 2019 word of the year. It's now 2020, and although climate is still an emergency, our country is dealing with a global health pandemic, an economic downturn, and renewed calls for racial justice. So where does climate change fall on the to-do list? Everywhere. Let me explain. Climate change largely exists inside a vertically integrated policy framework. But instead of siloing today's most pressing problems, we need to horizontally integrate them with each other. We can no longer afford to overlook the interconnected, overlapping complexities inherent in our world today. If we integrate climate change with gender equity, we begin to see how certain issues disproportionately impact women versus men and vice versa. For example, did you know that fully two-thirds of jobs lost in the wake of Hurricane Katrina were those lost by women? Or that women and children are 14 times more likely to be harmed when climate disasters strike? Did you know that among those displaced by climate change, 80% are women? Candidates need detailed, horizontally integrated plans to address climate change in a way that accounts for the needs of all stakeholders, and gender mainstreaming matters. Learn more about how the changing climate impacts gender equity by going to thevotingguide.com and accessing the 2020 Gender Equity Voting Guide. It's a free resource to help you gender mainstream 15 of this year's most pressing election issues. Until next time, be brave.